Hello there, welcome back to another game of Star Citizen. Today I wanted to do some missions. First I had planned to do some investigation missions, but I didn't get any interesting ones currently, so I decided to accept two other missions, which are illegal. So those are delivery missions. I have to get boxes from one location to the other, and they are at the same location, so it's very useful, but someone is annoying me here. but I could get caught and be sent into prison. So I haven't tried that before. I was never went to prison before. Never had a real crime stat. But maybe we can do it without and just cash in on the money. Okay. Let's see. Pet number 4. And I'm not 100% sure if those missions actually work. I've seen a bug report where someone had problems, but it was a quite old bug report, so maybe it's fixed. And it sounded a little bit like he got something confused there, so maybe it's not actually bugged. But we're going to see about that. And if it is, I'm going to check regularly for... first, let me increase the music volume a little bit. Some background music. And I will regularly check if there are any interesting investigation missions. The only ones that popped up so far were finding people in caves. And I hate caves, so I'm not going to do that. I hope for some data retrieval. I've seen some screenshots of those missions. They look very cool. I'm not 100% sure if they just happen to not show up currently, or if you need a reputation with some mission giver or something like that, or if it's for another patch. Or okay. I want to get in the ship, please, not on the ship. But yeah, I'm going to check. Maybe they just show up later on and I could either switch over if I see them, or finish those missions here first. Ugh, come on. Let me get in the ship here. Thank you. So those missions I've accepted give 50k each, which is a lot. I mean, yes, they are illegal, but if I can do that in one run, getting 30k, that would be really nice for just some delivery. Not 100% sure if that works, but what's the life without any risk? Oh, okay, pick up. Could you specify this a little? Is that on the planet or? Okay, I guess that's on the planet, but I can't. Okay, I can't select any of those. Okay, now I can. So I guess I have to find that myself, which kind of makes sense for something illegal. Just curious, am I going to fly over somewhere, or am I really doing this completely manually? I mean, I'm already kind of close. Do I see the marker here? Yeah, it's over there. But I can't jump there, right? Oh, I can! No, that's not the marker. Not sure if I should jump there. Each 190 kilometers. So I'm here. I mean, okay, as long as I'm on full speed here, it's not that bad. Is something I can maybe jump towards? And when I see that, that's only 200 kilometers and I get down into atmosphere, which will slow me down a lot. I don't think that this will save us any time. So I'm just going to fly there manually. Will take a little while, but it's not too bad, right? It's not much more than your typical bigger quantum jump. So while we're doing that, are there any new investigation missions? No, only these missions where you have to go in a cave. And yeah, as I said, I hate caves, and you have to go down there quite deep to get those missions, and it's only 4,000. I mean, if you combine it with personal mining, the payout is okay-ish if you're really fast and you know how to navigate those caves, which I don't. But yeah, no, I tried that once and I got motion sick and frustrated and not going to do that again. I rather fly over here. Okay, we're already down to 700 kilometers. It's not too bad. And I hope that mission works. Because from what I've seen, those investigation missions where you have to retrieve the data look quite cool, because you really get to some crash sites of ships that crash on planets and you retrieve the data there. And I actually thought I also seen that you reboot and do other stuff there. Looked kind of involved for Star Citizen mission, at least. Yeah, I might do some more research. If they don't show up, I have to see, maybe it's something that you have to get other way. I mean, probably here for the mission tables, you can see you got the contract ratings, and as you see, I don't have anything here. Though there is no investigation contract type, but... Or maybe you have to do some personal missions first. It's part of a mission chain, maybe. Yeah, as I said, I'm not quite sure. I thought they might just show up, and they didn't. But I get those two missions. I can show you here. Quick run, and they are 50k each, and reclamation, disposal, orphanage. So they have the exact same route. So I hope I can just switch them over and pick up both at once and deliver them both. And I will just take that money and hope it's not getting reset with the next update that might probably, probably next week. The last test universe invitation wave is not out yet, so that's the reason why I'm still playing here. If I had access to the test universe, I would try that out, but no, I didn't. I guess you have to do more bug reporting and stuff like that, or maybe pay more. I'm not sure if that's connected. Don't want to start any conspiracies here, but yeah. I'm not very surprised that I don't get invite for the earlier waves, and yeah, it's fine. I mean, we get that patch in our hands early enough. And it's not like I'm going to present anything completely new that nobody has seen anywhere else, so should be fine. Okay. Down to 500 kilometers. Is that water? Is that a water reflection? It looks really strange. I mean, is the sun shining through the planet? That's weird. Okay, that's the sun up there. But it doesn't, it gets completely reflected. Okay, maybe there's some strange particles in the atmosphere that caused this. Let me try not to get lower here because my speed, I'm slowing down when I'm going too low. Don't want to be caught by gravity here, or it will take even longer. So it's too early to descend here. Okay, speed is climbing up again. My beautiful 300i is doing what's possible here to get us there as quick as possible. Yeah. Okay, I guess we can fly in a straight line now, more or less. Ooh, G-forces. Have to be careful. Don't really understand them always. I don't know what I did there, actually. I mean, probably my ship was still moving in the other direction when I turned or something like that. Okay, we're at 460. Yeah, delivery missions are really relaxed. Don't have to do much. See, I don't even touch mouse or keyboard. Game is playing by itself. Star Citizen, your newest idle game. Nah. It's a little different. Oh, it is water. Okay. Well, that's an ocean. So that reflection is probably right then, more or less. I mean, wouldn't expect it to be so bright through the clouds and fog, but who am I to tell, right? Okay, 390. I guess I can unspool the quantum here. That's just putting annoying markers on the screen. All right. We are getting there. I mean, fuel shouldn't be an issue here. At least not yet. Maybe I have to do a refuel stop, but yeah, I mean, at 92% still. I didn't use any quantum fuel yet, so. Okay, I think I'm keeping it at that height so I can see the marker. Hey, let's be. Sitting there very concentrated. And as you can see, when I move my ship, you can actually see the character move. Ha! So cool. Whoops. Okay. Didn't actually want to change my course here, but alright. I'd say that at about maybe 200 kilometers I'm going down. I mean, I'm up 41 kilometers currently, so if I get at that distance, I can go straight down. But yeah, we do a nice curve somewhere in between. And I really hope there's no police catching us, because yes, that can happen, and I guess that's how we get our crime stat, if we get caught there. So we should be careful if we do any stops in between. On the other hand, checking out prison could also be cool. I mean, I'm not really trying to do that, but I guess you have to go to prison once in your citizen's life, at least. I mean, I'm not sure how much merits you get for transporting those illegal boxes, if that's a big felony or if it's okay-ish still. Okay. We're almost at 200 kilometers. I think I'm still flying a little closer. Flying at full speed is really much faster than not flying at full speed. So you get a real advantage when you stay out of atmosphere and gravity. And I mean, we are already descending a little bit. We were at 45,000, now it's 39. Okay. I wonder where we end up there. Ooh, there could be enemies trying to prevent me from getting the boxes. I hope that's not the case. Not even sure if I have a gun with me. I'm going to run very fast. The AI will never catch me. Okay. I guess it's about time to go a little down here. And we completed the first part of the trip. I mean, I guess that the place where we drop off those boxes might probably also be not something where we can directly quantum travel. But we'll see about that when we're there. And what the fuel says. Okay. I think now I can more or less go directly for the target. We don't have the atmosphere entry effect yet. That's also in the next update. It's coming very soon. And those entry effects look awesome. I mean, probably not so much on this ship, but I've seen some videos on the big ships and they're really bursting up in flames. It's a real inferno. Though you don't actually see it. That's something I wonder. When you're flying a big white ship like the 600i or 890 Jump, it's not getting blackened by the flames. I think that, well, probably they use some special paint coating there. I mean, those ships shouldn't be black each time you go to your atmosphere. You don't want to do a new paint job for your ship each time. So maybe there's an explanation for that. But could also be cool to have that as a temporary effect. I mean, maybe that's planned, maybe it's still missing. I don't know all the small features they were talking about. Okay, we see our first clouds here. And the first mountain ranges. Yeah, Hurston is a cool planet. Don't like the almost magenta purple color scheme of the rocks so much. I always feel it looks a little artificial. Maybe just because I haven't visited a place on Earth that has these colored rocks, but other than that, the sunlight and the rest is really cool. And I also hope they get in real clouds very soon, because that flat cloud texture is really getting kind of old. I mean, that's at least something I know they're working on to a certain extent. And I guess that's also something that will be part of Squadron 42, which is their main development priority right now. So you don't see so many changes in the Persistence universe. And yeah, one of the reasons is that they focus to get the single player campaign out first, at least in a beta state. Well, I guess they want to finish it, so probably they continue to prioritize until game is finished. Okay, someone is taking off here. I'm not alone. Doesn't look like he's trying to attack me. Maybe it's not a pirate, maybe someone that did the same mission here. Ooh, the weather is really bad. Okay. As you can see, you don't see anything. Ooh. Yikes. Okay. Well, let me get a little closer. And then I try to pick up both boxes and get them in my ship. I mean, that's still kind of easy. It's flying in atmosphere will also get a lot more difficult with the next update, because currently the ships more or less behave the same regardless if you're in space or in atmosphere. And sorry again for the bad frame rate. My GPU really doesn't like those particle effects and storms. So that's the Achilles heels of my machine currently. But I'm waiting to upgrade until the ray tracing cards become more mainstream. Oh, let's see, how close have I landed? How much do I have to walk? And will I, ooh, there's a lot of grass here. Okay. Well, at least I don't have any countdown for hazardous environment. Okay. Well, I guess it's in there. We get the first box, then we switch over the tracking to the other mission and hopefully just get the second one. Oh, it's a normal retrieval thing. Which is fine. Oh, not normal, it's flickering. It's a hacked retrieval machine. Maybe. Yeah. And we have to be careful when we drop them off, that we drop them off in the right order. Well, if it's at the same position, it might not make a difference, but you can really get confused if you're transporting multiple boxes and you forget which one goes with which mission. Kind of nice out here. The weather would be a little better. Could see myself staying here for a while. But we have no time. We have to do our missions here. Okay, now please get in there, not on top of the ship. Thank you. We just drop that off wherever. Not drop, but place. Okay, that's our number one. Okay, don't make the mistake to open your Mobi glass while some animations are playing. That can be really hurtful. Okay, well, it still says pickup over there, so maybe I just try to push that button again. Maybe I don't even have to change the tracking of the mission. Yeah, I mean, why should I need to do that? It's just tracking, not active missions or something like that. A lot of junk. What's that ship there? Not quite sure. Give me more, give me more. Okay, that actually worked. Oh, that looks a little different, right? Fragile. Well, whatever, right? I'm very cautious as the postman that delivers my packages here in real life, which doesn't mean a lot. Yeah. Yeah, today was kind of a bad day. First, I threw down a glass full of chocolate cream and had the glass splinters all over my apartment. and try to get rid of that. And after that, my handy, my smartphone battery, yeah, it didn't blew up, but it bulged, which can be quite dangerous. So I turned that off and put it somewhere safe. And now I had to order a new smartphone, which isn't too bad because that one was 7 years old and I already planned to replace it at some point. So I guess that's today then. But now I have to wait 3 days for the delivery without a smartphone. But actually, that could be something good to live without your smartphone for a few days. Why not? Okay, let's get the engines back on. And we lift off. We lift off. Huh? We lift off? Did I misclick? Engines on. Maybe the boxes are too heavy. Oh, okay, there we go. Well, so far so good. Let's just hope that the drop-off works and we don't get caught. I mean, I'm not 100% sure that these missions here are illegal. I just know that many of the personal missions are, and it felt kind of shady what I had to do there. Though, I mean, getting spacesuits to the orphanage, that's not suspicious at all, right? An orphanage needs a hell of a lot of spacesuits. Yeah. Okay, so let's see, where is the drop-off? That's an R-Corp, okay. And we're flying over to R-Corp. When we're in atmosphere at least. Out of atmosphere? Okay, that should be enough, I guess, but... delivery drop-off. Ah, okay, we don't have to do the in-between jump there. Okay, I can select it. Let's try this again. Yeah, I don't need that in-between jump. Okay, still calibrating, and off we go. Really wonder where the orphanage is. I mean, R-Corp is only city planet, so I guess we'll land on top of some building there, probably, and get inside of that building. Though, don't get your hopes up high. Those buildings are only one room on the roof. It's not that exciting. Well, 22 million kilometers to go, so I guess that is probably enough to do a little reading comprehension here. Haven't done that in a while, but why not, right? Let's see, what short story do we have here? Yeah. Can you please open this? Thank you. Okay, oh, maybe I have a... No, I don't. Bear in mind closely that I did not see any actual visual horror at the end. To say that a mental shock was the cause of what I inferred, the last straw which sent me racing out of the lonely Ackley farmhouse and through the wild domed hills of Vermont in a commemorative motor at night, is to ignore the plainest fact of my final experience. Notwithstanding the deep extent to which I shared the information and speculations of Henry Ackley, the things I saw and heard, and the admitted vividness of the impressions produced on me by these things, I cannot prove even now whether I was right or wrong in my hideous inference. For after all, Ackley's disappearance establishes nothing. People found nothing amiss in his house despite the bullet marks on the outside and inside. It was just as though he had walked out casually for a ramble in the hills and failed to return. There wasn't even a sign that a guest had been there, or that those horrible cylinders and machines had been stored in the study. That he had mortally feared the crowded green hills and endless trickle of brooks among which he had been born and reared means nothing at all either. For thousands are subject to just such morbid fears. Eccentricity, moreover, could easily account for his strange acts and apprehensions toward the last. The whole matter began, so far as I'm concerned, with the historic and unprecedented Vermont flood on November 3rd, 1927. I was then, as now, an instructor of literature at Miskatonic University in Arkham, Massachusetts, and an enthusiastic amateur student of New England folklore. Shortly after the flood, amidst the varied reports of hardship, suffering, and organized relief which filled the press, there appeared certain odd stories of things found floating in some of the swollen rivers, so that many of my friends embarked on curious discussions and appealed to me to shed what light I could on the subject. I felt flattered at having my folklore study taken so seriously and did what I could to belittle the wild, vague tales which seemed so clearly an outgrowth of old rustic superstitions. It amused me to find several persons of education who insisted that some stratum of obscure, distorted fact might underlie the rumors. The tales thus brought to my notice came mostly through newspaper cuttings. The one yarn had an oral source and was repeated to a friend of mine in a letter from his mother in Hardwick, Vermont. The type of thing described was essentially the same in all cases, though there seemed to be three separate instances involved, one connected with the Winooski River near Montpellier, another attached to the West River in Windham County beyond Newfane, and a third centering in the Passumpsic in Culloden County above Lyndonville. Of course, many of the stray items mentioned are the instances, but on analysis, they all seem to boil down to these three. In each case, country folk reported seeing one or more very bizarre and disturbing objects in the surging waters that poured down from the unfrequented hills, and there was widespread tendency to connect these sites with a primitive, half-forgotten cycle of whispered legend which old people resurrected for the occasion. What people thought they saw were organic shapes, not quite like any they had ever seen before. Naturally, there were many human bodies washed along by the streams in that tragic period, but those who described these strange shapes felt quite sure that they were not human, despite some superficial resemblances in size and general outline. Nor said the witnesses could they have been any kind of animal known to Vermont. They were pinkish things, about 5 feet long, with crustaceous bodies bearing vast pairs of dorsal fins or membranous wings, and several sets of articulated limbs, and with a sort of convoluted ellipsoid covered with multitudes of very short antennae, where a head would ordinarily be. It was really remarkable how closely the reports from different sources tended to coincide, though the wonder was lessened by the fact that the old legends shared at one time throughout the hill country furnished a morbidly vivid picture which might well have colored the imaginations of all the witnesses concerned. Okay, so that we're back here at Arcorp. let's see where we have to go and how far that is away. Okay. Is that probably on a moon then? And not on Arcorp itself. Or is it? Okay, that's kind of weird. It's just in space? I mean, I see something in that direction. Ah, there it is. Yeah. Over to the moon, Lyria. That makes more sense. Yeah, the other marker that I've seen there was myself, the boxes I have in the ship. That always confuses me a little. Whoosh! That doesn't take very long. I've actually just recently seen a movie about that story I was just reading. It was quite cool. It was an independent movie and it showed a little, but they were very truthful to the original material. And the movie had a cool atmosphere. It's very creepy and ominous. Okay, so another 500 kilometers in that direction. Cruise speed, please. But without an atmosphere, that should be a little faster to get there. And then we're rich, maybe, if it works. I mean, I've seen many delivery missions not working at all, but I hope we're lucky. Okay, I wanted to check in if there are any interesting investigation missions. No new one, nope. I wonder if anyone has to complete one of those before a new one shows up and nobody wants to do these and that's the reason. I mean, I could accept a few of those and abandon them right away and see if something new pops up. I think that's what I'm going to do, what I'm going to try after finishing that mission here. I don't know if that's how it works. I have no idea which missions you will get presented when and how. I know that they are shared on the server, so someone else can take a mission and then it's not available to you. But I don't know if you abandon a mission, if it's going back to the pool or if a new one is generated. I would expect the first to be the case. I mean, otherwise you can just accept all missions, abandon all missions, and then nobody else can do any missions. That would be kind of unfair. Yeah, the texturing of that moon doesn't look too good. It looks quite repetitive and weird, but I wonder if that gets a little better. The next update is also bringing new height maps, which increase the detail of features. But I don't know how it looks here. I mean, if you get close, it's better, but looks at least not very natural when you're far away. Okay, I have to be a little more careful here because I won't automatically slow down. I don't want to fly down there full speed. That can happen quite quickly, that you just crash. That wouldn't be a nice ending for our mission here, right? Oh damn, it's 300 kilometers away, so that's probably on the other side. Give me a second. Yep. Yeah. Okay. My bad. Let's see, can we do a little jump just somewhere else? I mean, we are at the maximum useless destination here. That's 285. That should be somewhere around the other side, I guess. So I'm going to try that. Yeah, my bad. So we're probably landing on the dark side of the moon. Ooh. Doesn't look too dark. Okay. Stop. I don't see the marker. It's too bright. Ah, over there. What? No, that's the wrong marker. Are both of these wrong? Oh, that's right. Okay, 100 and something. That's rather close. So we should be on the right side of the planet now, but eh? Where is that pointing towards? Uh-oh. It's the delivery drop off in the middle of the planet, of the moon. continue to fly in the general direction. Are we getting closer? 125, 123. We are, but this seems weird. I mean, I could try to find. No, that won't work. If the marker is wrong, you can't deliver the box. So it doesn't even help if I could find out somewhere else where the orphanage is, but. Well, we are still getting closer though. For whatever reason, he set the marker down there. Could speed up a little more. If I'm careful, should be fine. Okay. Yeah, it was a little weird, but it seems that we are able to reach it. Move, my little ship, move, fly like the wind. Almost there. Okay, well. Gas. I guess there we are. A little fast. Okay. Something there? Yes, there's something. The orphanage. I wonder what children live there. Okay. The entry is on the left side, I guess. Actually, that's kind of a nice location here. Let me just turn off the engines and see, maybe I want to take a shot here. It's very sunny and bright. Check something. I have that activated, yep, okay. Let's get out of here then. Box number one and box number two. They are still here. Fine. That's at least a good sign. Ooh. Those shadows are cool. Actually looks like I would imagine a moon to look like. Come on, me delivering those things for the orphanage is also kind of nice. Okay, but I want to move in the light here, please. That's too much. Where am I looking? I want to have some light on the face, so maybe just straight to the camera here. Alright. Enough playing around. Okay, where should I get that? Okay, I guess I just place it here then. Yes. Nice, that worked. Do I get all the monies now? I got all the monies. Woohoo! Okay, now let's get the second box for all the monies number two. Might have to do another few shots after I'm finished here. Work first. Okay. The small one. You leaving? Yeah. Open. Cycle. And place. All the verbs. Nope, not carry. Oh. Is there no place left? No space left? Check. Okay. First, let me pick that up again. And now. That's this one here, right? No, it's on this side. Well, they have a very specific system here for their box delivery, but it worked. Awesome. We just made ourselves 30k. I approve. That was worth the time. Definitely. I mean, it's only been 45 minutes. And we didn't even need any special ships or anything. If those were repeatable, you could make a lot of money there, I guess. Ooh, I'm going to try something. As I said, I did like the shadow there. So maybe I can do something fancy with that. That looks really alien. I'm not sure, is that cool or is that just weird? I mean, do you even get that? Okay, I guess maybe if we get up a little. And if you down, it's not. Hmm. Nah, I don't like. Okay, let me try something. We don't get that shadow on our ship, but maybe we can get it on the rock back there. Does that work? It kinda does. It's not looking that big anymore, though. Okay, that's not the greatest texture resolution over here. Has to be something I can do with that. Ooh, I mean, I could use the shadow of my ship. That's at least a little bigger. Okay, let me try something here. Actually, I like that. With the rocks and all the stuff. That's kind of cool. And now, let me try to throw a cool shadow with my ship, maybe. Not sure if that will work, but we'll figure it out. Okay. Actually, with the ship, the rock might be too small and the ship too big. The Aurora might have been the better choice there, but let's see. Okay. There's that rock. So we'll, oh, it's down. Is that the rock? Seems so small now, but oh. I'm not as close as it looks, actually. As you can see. And the ship is a little too big. Okay, I try one this way, and then and I try to move away a little further. Not sure how far those shadows and camera angles work. Oh, okay, now the shadow's getting blurry. I don't like that too much. Okay, it's still sharp here. That actually doesn't make such a big difference to the first one, right? Okay, maybe we get the shadow on the ground instead. Where did it go? Ah, over there. Okay, I have to get closer here. Ship. Just let me. Yeah. It's hard. Okay, I think I'm making this a little too complicated here. Let me try something else. It's not as clear cut as I hoped it would be. You can make out its shape, but barely. Okay. I think that doesn't work with the shadow there, but all right, forget it. Let me just get back. Going to fly over to what is it called? I'm not going to land on R-Corp. I'm going to fly to its space station and I'm going to land there. And then we earned all the money. Let me just see out of curiosity. There are no new investigation bodies, missions. So going to accept a few and abandon them. But I don't think that will make an actual difference. One, two, three, four, five, six. Yeah, still six. Nope, they're all the same. Oh, too bad. 28 delivery missions. Nobody's in the mood to do those. Yep. I mean, I guess you could make some money there if you're really optimizing those routes here. So many missions, there have to be some good combinations in there. But yeah, as I said, ooh, okay. Already got another of those. Ah, no, those is. That's a different route at least. From orphanage, and I. Stop? Ah. Okay. Yeah, whatever, but wow, those personal delivery missions are really worth a lot. Not sure if those are illegal, as I said, but they didn't catch us. We earned 30k, so I'm fine with that, and I think I'm going to continue to do those in the future. Seems easily earned money. And where is Bungini Ini Dini Point? There it is. Yep. Or maybe next time we take the mission that starts at the orphanage and we are already quite close. That would also be fine. Nice. I mean, that's already enough. Yeah, to rent a prospector for another day. Though I'm going to wait with the update if I'm actually going to do that, because I'm not quite sure with the new flight atmosphere flight system. You can't just stay up in the air and mine with your prospector. You actually have to land. And I want to know how much time that cost. I think it won't be a big difference. I think it would still be very effective to do mining that way, but I'm not going to spend 50k to bet on that before I've heard anything about it. And maybe I'll research if they have fixed the issues with the asteroid mining. As far as I know, that doesn't work currently because the asteroids will just despawn when you crack them. But asteroid mining, actually, theoretically, I think, is even more efficient than planet surface mining. So, if they did fix that, that could be an option to go. And it would be very interesting. I didn't do that before, and I'm curious how that feels. I think it's kind of cool to fly through an asteroid field and do mining there. Alright, let's get our landing permission. Hup. Where should we go? Hup. Ah, perfect. Right this way. I like the flight behavior of the 300i. It's a little too fast sometimes, actually, but feels cool. I mean, the Aurora is easier to fly, actually, and easier to land. It's a perfect starter ship. But this is a lot of fun also, and I'm really curious how the 300i behaves in atmosphere flight. Because it should behave quite fine. It has wings and stuff. And it's not too big. Okay, let's refuel here and then I'm going to enter the station and call it a day. Come on, start refueling. Thank you. Okay. Let's just get out of here. Still shows me the pet for whatever reason, but that shouldn't make a big difference. I mean, maybe if I didn't land here correctly, I have to claim my ship next time, but yeah, who cares? With all the money we made today, that's not an issue. Right. Bye. Bye, brain. Yeah, I named my ship the Brain. Pinky and the Brain. What was that? Okay. Don't die on the elevator, please. All right. Guess there we are. Are we? Yes, we are. That was a really lucrative day. I'm just going to upload the stream later on YouTube. If you want to check out the beginning, and thanks for stepping by. Hope you enjoyed the stream. If you did so, considering following my channel. And with that, see ya.